Well, there is a family of mummies spending the summer near Forest Park.
Tonight, Fox 2's Patrick Clark shares some tales from the crypts inside this new exhibit at the St. Louis Science Center.
If you take your daddy or mommy to see the Mummies of the World exhibition at the St. Louis Science Center, try to remember that these were once real people too.
They had a lot of impact on those around them, and we want to make sure that every individual inside is treated as ethically and responsibly as possible. We refer to them by name whenever possible. We want to make sure that as you go through, you're not just learning about the culture, but you're learning about the story that the individual can tell.
The traveling exhibit is bringing these members of the mummy family to this family-friendly science spot through September 6th.
Yeah, the detail work on the face is always pretty ornate. Meant to represent the person that's inside of it. If I remember correctly, it's so that the soul remembers who to return to, can recognize you.
What remains true of this exhibit might be the morbid curiosity of what eventually awaits us all, from animals to individuals that are thousands of years old from around the globe.
Behind me, we've got MUMOB, which stands for the Mummy at Maryland University of Baltimore. That would have been from 1994, and although it looks very Egyptian, it was actually part of an experimental process to see if we could replicate the Egyptian system of mummification.
Keep your eyes open for the young king looking back at you.
No Egyptian exhibition is complete without King Tut, and although we don't have any of his objects or King Tut himself in here, we do have a reconstruction of what he would have looked like.
Make no mistake, the Mummies of the World is a serious discussion for today's families about life, death, and beyond.
It's such an interesting window into some of the universal human elements, how we deal with life and death, that kind of thing. But it's also a way to see that people weren't really so different all this time.
Patrick Clark, Fox 2 News.